here we are, 5:03 a.m. Today there's supposed to be an eclipse happening right around 5:30, which is right about sunrise. There's a couple factors at play this morning. Cloud cover, I was a bit worried that that was gonna be a big issue. It looks like the cloud cover should be okay. We've got a little bit of fog situation that I can already see going on down by the river. And the wind seemed a little bit squirrely when I was loading up, but we'll see how that pans out. Hopefully we have visibility and we can see this majestic eclipse happen. All right, the time has come. We're kind of set up a little down crosswind, which isn't really favorable. Like, the wind was dead when we laid out, but now it's kind of blowing. So I don't know how that number's gonna go. Sunrise is gonna be in that direction, which looks pretty clear and beautiful. I've only got 4 liters of gas, so we're not gonna be up for long, but hope this looks cool.
Steady, the air's a little bit turbulent this morning. Surprisingly, the winds aloft up here are cranking. We'll get some more altitude, try to get in smoother air, get a better view of this thing. The good thing is the winds are coming from the direction of the sun, so that means we just have to stay pointed towards the sun and we're fine. If it was opposite, we'd be trying to look behind ourselves. That's incredible! How sick is that? I don't think I've ever seen an eclipse in my life. At least not that I recall. That's just trippy. The sun looks like a moon. Man, on the camera it doesn't look quite as good as real life because like the clouds kind of wash it out and make it look more or less crispy, but in real life when you squint a little bit you can see like full definition, the little crescent sun. It always trips me out, the fact that with a paramotor, like, I was in bed like 30 minutes ago and my alarm was just going off. Now I'm literally on top of the world. Got an airport down here, the reservoirs, beautiful eclipse going on, river fog. Oh, dope. There's a plane. I don't even see that. Oh, now it looks mega washed out, but there's an airliner crossing through out there. I'm curious, I would say we've got to be 6,000 feet. You just pull up the GPS app. Not too far off. 5,125 feet. That's going to be a no-go on the phone situation. Man, I can barely even see it with my naked eye now. And the sun's bright enough at this point that if you look at it, now you're blinded, you can't see anything else. Well, that was freaking neat. Never seen an eclipse before. I gotta stop looking at it. Not gonna be able to see where I'm going pretty soon.
dude, you would have been proud. I came in, I was like, looking at the windsock, I was like, oh, is it moving at all? Because obviously I want to land into the wind.
Mm-hmm.
And as I'm flying out that way at like 150 feet or so, my engine just dies. And I'm like, oh, over that tree line, and I just did like a 180 swoop.
Nice.
And like basically planed across the whole field.
That's awesome. That was all the gas you had?
Yeah. It was like perfect timing.
Nailed it.
There at the end, I turned and went downwind and clocked 57 miles per hour. And
damn.
Then I turned around and that's like four.
Really?
Like, crap.
So I hope you guys enjoyed that clip situation. It's one of those things that I feel like it's always like going to be better seeing it with your naked eye, but I already looked at the shots I got and I think they came out pretty well for the situation we were given. Anyways, I'm working on a project right now. I have to change my oil in the truck because it's almost due, and I'm planning on doing a little mini road trip with the toy hauler this weekend. And it's not just going to be me. We don't have a verified list, but a bunch of my local paramotor friends are going to be coming along, so it'll be like a cool little northeast paramotor dudes trip. That's the goal. We'll hit up maybe two or three different sites, go like Friday, Saturday, Sunday, get the toy hauler back out on the road, which I'm stoked for. I'm going to my parents' house to change the oil because they have like a better setup for that sort of thing. So that's what I'm going to do. And then maybe tonight it might be flyable again if it doesn't thunderstorm. So I'm just mixing up some fresh paramotor gas. Motul normally like pours like molasses, but when it's super hot out, so I just picked up an old friend, the Adam 80 Maverick. I've been loaning her out for a little while. Here's the scoop. Myself, Jeff, Judson, Josh, and Dan are all going on this mini road trip. We're gonna hit probably three different spots this weekend. A bunch of the guys are gonna be crashing in the toy hauler with me in the bunks. It's gonna be sick. I just gassed up with a whole lot of petroleum. All prepared. Look at that view. Flown over this bridge several times in videos. Right up there is an island I actually landed on right around the bend. But anyway, I just made a wrong turn, so I'm gonna bang a U-turn and go get some Chick-fil-A. What I was saying is I fueled up with a whole bunch of gasoline for this trip. $4 a gallon for the premium stuff. And I know that comment alone is gonna stir up some political drama in the comments, so that's why I said it. So we officially have three paramotors in the living room situation now. Here's the scoop. I'm really tired. I've been up since 4:30 a.m. I've got almost everything ready to go on the toy hauler for tomorrow's adventure. Just gotta pack the essentials. Hope you guys enjoyed the sunrise this morning as much as I did. If you haven't, drop a like if you enjoyed the video. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on future episodes, and check out the Risky Biscuits Co. merch down in the description. Till the next one, peace.